Well, hello, my fabulous friends. Man, this is so good to, it's so good for you to see me. I guess you remember me from back in fall break time. Well, remember my name is remember. Mr. Greg told me to remember to tell y'all something. Yeah, hey. Anyway, hello. My name is Octavious Nickelodeon for you new kids out there that are tuning in. And I am one of Mr. Greg's best friends, and I'll fill in for him, every now and then. I'm here today because of something about his sore arm flipping pancakes. I have no idea what he's talking about, but it is so great to see you guys. It's so great for you guys to see me. And as you can tell, I am fired up and ready to go. But first of all, let's go sing and get in the mood for worship for the Lord. I'll be right back.
Across
Sorry, I was going to be back after the song went off, but I had to go get the ball down the hill. You ever shot the ball and it go rolling down the hill? Yeah, that kind of happens to me a lot when I shoot the ball. But hey, it is March Madness, and I'm here to talk about it. Mr. Greg said, talk about something about March, and the only thing I can think about is basketball. Y'all ever heard of March Madness, right? Well, maybe, maybe not. How many of you watch basketball? Well, okay, so how many of you play basketball? Well, okay, anyway, it's March Madness, and it's ready to get cranked up, and I am ready to watch some basketball and watch some marching. What? Marching? That didn't even make sense. But anyway, so let's get ready to worship to the Lord too, because I am also fired up about being here and just talking about Jesus and just what's happening with Jesus. But so, when you get finished watching this, go watch some basketball and then watch this again. Let's go check out the story.
Jesus and his disciples were in Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. Long ago, God delivered his people from slavery in Egypt. He sent 10 plagues to Egypt. And during the 10th plague, the firstborn of the Egyptians died. The Israelites smeared the blood of a lamb on their doorpost, and God kept them safe. He passed over their houses. God said that once a year, the Israelites should celebrate the Passover to remember how he rescued them. He told his people when and how to celebrate. On the day when the Jewish people were supposed to kill the Passover lamb, Jesus sent Peter and John to get the meal ready. He said, "Go into the city and you will meet a man carrying a jug of water. Follow him." Jesus said that the man would go to a house and the homeowner would show Peter and John a large room upstairs with furniture in it. That was the place Jesus wanted them to get the Passover meal ready. So Peter and John did as Jesus said. When the Passover meal was ready, Jesus and his disciples reclined to eat. Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." The disciples were upset, but Jesus knew this was part of God's plan. Peter said he would never betray Jesus, but Jesus said Peter would deny him 3 times. Then Jesus took the bread, gave thanks to God for it, broke it, and then gave it to his disciples to eat. Jesus said, "This is my body, which I am giving for you. Do this to remember me." Jesus took the cup and gave it to his disciples. They drank from it, and Jesus said, "This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for many." They sang a hymn together, and then they went out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus knew he would be arrested and would suffer. Then he would die on the cross to take the punishment for the sins of the world. On the 3rd day, Jesus would rise from the dead. The new covenant says that everyone who turns away from sin and trusts in Jesus' death and resurrection will be forgiven of his sins and will have eternal life.
Oh, hey, oh, sorry. What an amazing story that was. Man, Jesus is so awesome, and I am so happy I could sit in for Mr. Greg. He'll be back next week. I'm pretty sure his elbow will be okay after those pancakes. And let's go check out and see what Pastor Brian has to say on the questions from kids. And man, I am already late for supper, and I don't want this to be my last one. See ya.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Violet from Columbus, Ohio asks,
"I'm already a Christian. Why is it important to keep thinking about what Jesus did for me?"
Violet, I love this question because it's so important. You know, when we think about the gospel, a lot of times we think it's just what we need to trust in Jesus to be saved, and then we're done with it. But that's not the gospel. That's true, of course, but the gospel is far more important and beautiful than that. You see, the gospel is how we understand life. It's how we understand everything. It's the story about how God loves us, provided Jesus to die for our sins, raise again, and provide not just forgiveness, but righteousness, meaning, purpose, everything. And so we're never done with the gospel. We never should tire of it. We should never put it on a shelf and say, let's move on with our lives, because there's nothing to move on to. It's all about the gospel, God's plan, what he's done, and what he's doing in us and through us. So for me, especially, it's important to remember the gospel day by day, because it remembers me the truth of God's goodness. A lot of times life feels hard. A lot of times it doesn't seem like God is being good to me. And the gospel reminds me that God is always good. It reminds me of why I'm here, that God is not done with me. It's not just about my salvation. It's about God using me to share the gospel with others so that they too might trust in Jesus and be saved. And it's about me living for God's glory. It's all about him and making much of him all around me. So we should never be done with the gospel. I want to encourage you, always, always remind yourself of the gospel every day, because we always need it. So here's a question back for you. How does your church celebrate the Lord's Supper, and what questions do you have about it?